Hello 11th class, this is the summary of chapter 8, conditional and iterative statements and lecture number 5. So what is statement now? The statements are the instructions given to the computer to perform any kind of action. Statements are of three types, that is empty statement, simple statement, compound statement. Now we will discuss the first one, that is empty statement. So the statement which does nothing is empty statement. Okay, the statement that perform nothing, it is your empty statement. So in Python, the empty statement is your pass statement. Now next is your simple statement. So the single executable statement is a simple statement in Python. For example, this name is equal to input, enter your name. So this is a single statement, so it is a simple statement. Next is the compound statement. So compound statement represents a group of statements executed as a unit. The compound statement has two parts, that is a header line which begins with a keyword and ends with a colon. Next is a body consisting of one or more Python statements, so each indented inside the header line. Now statement flow control. So now in this flow control, there are three parts, that is sequence, selection and iteration. Now the first one is a sequence. The sequence construct means the statements are being executed sequentially. Means first the statement 1 will execute, then statement 2 will execute, then statement 3 will execute. Next is your selection construct. It means that the execution of these statements depending upon a condition test. If the condition is true, then the block of statement will execute. And if the condition is false, then it will not go in the loop and just come out of the loop and just go jump on the normal statements. Next is your statement flow control. So in this, the iteration constructs mean repetition of a set of statements depending upon a condition or test. Okay. So here this for loop iterating in sequence, this is a for loop. So here if this is a condition, that last item in sequence, if it is true, then if it is false, then it will just body of the loop that execute this statement. Okay, and the condition, when the condition is become false, it will just out of the loop. Next is flow charts. So the flow chart, they graphically represent the flow of a program. So there are four basic shapes that used in a flow chart. That is, oval is used to start and end. Parallelogram, that is input and output. Rectangle is used for calculations. And diamond, that is selection structure. So here is the diagram that this show the oval, input out processing, then rectangle calculation and the selection structure. Now next is conditional statements. So the conditional statements are features of a programming language which perform different computations or actions depending on whether the given condition evaluates to true or false. And the conditional statements are of four types, that is if, if else, if elif and nested if else. Now if statement. So the if statement that is used to run a statement conditionally, that is if given condition is true, then only the statement given in if block will be executed. You can see in the syntax, if the condition is true, then the if block will get executed. Now if else statement. So in this case, if else statement, if given condition is true, then the statement in if block will be executed, otherwise the else part of the statement will get executed. So this is the syntax. If the condition is this, then this if statement block will execute. Otherwise, this else statement block will execute. Next is your if elif statement. So what it says, that if elif is used for execution of statements that based on several alternatives. When you have more than one condition, then you will use the if elif. So here we use one or more elif, short form of else if clause. So this Python evaluates each condition in true and executes the statements corresponding to the first if that is true. If none of the expressions are true, and an else clause will be executed. Now next is nested if statement. So a statement is a a state nested if is an if statement that is a target of another if statement. Nested if statement means an if statement within another if statement. Iteration. So iterative or the looping statements in a program are executed when a certain set of statements needs to be executed multiple times in a loop. That is iteration. When you are executed a simple statement again and again, okay, then writing it many times, it is better that we have to use the iterative statement or the looping statement. Next is the set of statements that are repeated again and again, that is called body of the loop. The condition on which the execution or exit of the loop depends is called the exit condition or test condition. Now types of loop. So there are two types of loop, that is for loop and while loop. So this for loop statement is used to iterate or repeat itself over a range of values or a sequence. So these values can be either numeric list, string or tuple. Now next is your for loop syntax. So this is a syntax. This for is a keyword, this is a control variable, in then sequence item in range, and then statements in the body of the loop, and else part is the optional. When the loop get over, then the else part will execute. Now the range function. The range is a built-in function in Python and is used to create a list containing a sequence of numbers starting with the start and ending with one less than the number than the stop. So here is the range function, and it says if the range is 10, then it will execute 0 to 9, because it says it will execute the one less than the number. So 10 is the number, 1 less than is 9, so it will print 0 to 9. Now range is 1 to 11, then it will print 1 to 10. Now the range is 0, 30 and 5, so 5 is a step value. So it will run first 0, then again 5, then 10, then 15, okay, till 25. Now this is the negative, so here the loop will start 0 to minus 8, okay, and it will print the values. So the arguments of range function must be integers, and the step parameter can be any positive or negative integer other than 0. Next is while loop. So the while statement in Python executes a block of code repeatedly as long as the test or control condition of the loop is true. So this is a test expression, then body of the while loop, then the statement just below while. Okay, if the test is true, then it will just go in body of while. If the test is condition is false, then it will just print the statements below the while loop. This is the syntax. This is a while test expression, condition you have to give. Now body of the while will get execute, and this else part is optional. It is executed when the test condition become false. Okay. Next is your infinite loop. So a loop that becomes an infinite loop if a condition never become false. Okay. This is an infinite loop. Nested loop. A loop may contain another loop as a part of its body. So the loop inside a loop is called a nested loop. Once the condition of outer loop is true, the control is transferred to the inner loop, and the inner loop is terminated first and then the outer loop terminates. So this is nested while loop. In this while loop is inside this while loop. So this is the outer loop and this one is the inner loop. Okay. This is the example of nested while loop, and its output will show this one. Now next is a nested for loop. In this is the inner outer loop, this one is the inner loop, and it will print the output accordingly. Now the output will of this code is this. Next are the jump statements. So jump statements in Python are used to alter the flow of a loop, like you want to skip a part of a loop or terminate a loop. So first one is a break statement. The break statement in Python is used to terminate the loop. Basically, break is used when you want to terminate any loop, then you have to use the break. So when you break statement will get executed, then that particular block will not get executed, and the next line that after the loop will get executed. And if a break statement is inside a nested loop, so it will terminate the innermost loop and then continue the outer loop. Example is, here is the example. So that is used to terminate the loop. So if the value of I is 7, then it will just break, okay, print it will print break, and then that particular value will not then when the value is 7, then this message will come. Next is, after break statement, control goes to next line, that pointing after the loop body. So in this, this is a break. So after this break, this line is there. So it is inside the loop body. So any code after the break statement will not get executed. Okay, so that statement is inside this if block, so it will not get executed. It will just execute this statement, because this is out of this if block. Okay, now next is, if a break statement is inside a nested loop, so it will terminate the innermost loop and continue the outer loop. So now you have to print the table 2 to 5 and each table up to 5 iterations only. So this is a loop, that is inner loop, and print table, this is the outer loop, so it will get print. If the value of j become 5, then it will just break the loop. Next is continue statement. So continue statement in Python is used to skip all the remaining statements in the loop and move controls back to the top of the loop. So here, when the value of I is 0 to 5, now when I is equal to 3, then it will just continue the loop, it will not print it. Okay, so the value of 3 will not get printed. So I hope the summary is clear to you now. Okay, so your homework is, you have to just revise the chapter. In the next class, I'll